semi-suburban community offers character and quaintness just south of the river. Some might call it a Victorian village, while others might call it a breath of good air, just like its name. Stay tuned to find out where we are today. If you are new to this channel, I'm Holly, and if you want to know everything about the Richmond metro area, well, you have come to the right place. Be sure to subscribe and click on the bell so you'll receive notifications each time I upload a new video, which will be about twice a week. I have people reaching out to me on a regular basis who are thinking about moving to Richmond, and I love hearing from y'all. Give me a call or shoot me a text at 804-380-6041 or send me an email, whichever is most convenient. I had a comment to do a video on Bonaire, so here we are. It's a community within Chesterfield County. Bonaire is convenient to downtown Richmond and is situated between Powhite Parkway, Midlothian Turnpike, and Huguenot Road. Richmond is not only the capital city of Virginia, but it also has tons of history, including Bonaire. So I thought we could start off by taking a look at some of the historical features in this area, including some of the beautiful Victorian homes. When Bonaire was established back in the 1870s, it was known as Upper Class Richmond's summer hideaway. The ornate Victorian cottages with floor-to-ceiling windows and sprawling porches were built during that time period. You can still see some of these houses in the historic district today as private residences. So let's start with this part of the community. The church that you see behind me was built in 1882 as a non-denominational chapel. It became Bonaire Presbyterian Church in 1884 and then Bonaire Christian Church in the 1960s. You'll notice that many of the houses in this area are named after the original owners. This home was built by Dr. Hazen in 1885. He was a minister at the church and also founded the former Bonaire School for Boys. Another interesting note about the Hazen family was that his son was a physician who was one of the first to use the x-ray. The original Bonaire Hotel was built in 1880, but burned down 9 years later. This building is known as the Bonaire Hotel Annex, which was built in 1881 for overflow crowds that came out to the resort. It was used as a dormitory for the Bonaire School for Boys, and later used by the public school system. Today, it's an apartment building. The Moore House was built by J. Blythe Moore, who was the president of the Bonaire Land and Improvement Company. This was the company that was chartered to build the Victorian Resort. Just down the street is the one original house in Bonaire with a flat roof, but has since been remodeled with a gabled roof. Our next stop is the Hazen Memorial Library. That name might sound familiar from earlier in this video. This library was built as a memorial to Dr. Hazen, and it was the first public library in Chesterfield County. It was open on Tuesday afternoons for tea and books until the 1960s. And this is the old Bonaire Post Office, which was built in 1916 and used until 1952. It served as the social center for people in Bonaire when they came to pick up their mail. The Talcott House remains the most elaborate house in the area with its lavender color and gingerbread trim. It was the third to be built in Bonaire. I'm sure it's no surprise that Bonaire has been recognized by both the federal and state governments as a historic district, and the community is committed to maintaining the historic elements. In fact, each year, the Bonaire Historical Society holds an annual Victorian Day Festival and parade in May. Next, we are going to head over to Bonaire's newest Victorian neighborhood. Here we are at Grand Summit. This community started in the 1970s, but returned to Bonaire's roots for inspiration. The average home price for the Bonaire community is around the mid-300,000s. However, this community is closer to the mid-500,000s. If you haven't already done so, be sure to like this video. It really helps me to know I'm producing content that is of interest to you.
Also, if you would like for me to explore an area for you, be sure to leave a comment below.
In terms of fun and recreation, there's something for everyone. Some communities have pools and clubhouses within the community, but if not, you also have the Bon Air Community Association available for you with 3 pools, 9 tennis courts, and a clubhouse for events. This community is also home of Huguenot Park, which has winding trails through the 53 acres of wooded land, as well as playgrounds. If you are shopping for antiques, be sure to check out the local antique stores.
No tour of Bon Air would be complete without touching on its variety of dining options. Joe's Inn is a classic family-owned restaurant in this area for almost 20 years. Their spaghetti a la Joe and spaghetti a la Greek are known by us locals as must-tries for anyone visiting the area. Our next stop hasn't been around as long as Joe's, but definitely has its own unique character and appeal. Perk Coffee and Lunchbox opened in 2015 by 2 VCU roommates. For those who aren't familiar with VCU, it stands for Virginia Commonwealth University, a Richmond-based university. This cafe focuses on locally sourced coffee and food. Whether you are meeting a friend for lunch or want to grab a quick coffee on a rainy day while your kids play in the tot area, this is a must-try location. Before we take a look at the schools, I wanted to do a quick drive through a subdivision that's within that average price point for this area of $300,000. This is Old Bon Air Place. You'll still see a lot of the same character and charm as within the historic district, but just at a little bit of a lower price point. Also, I wanted to mention Old Bon Air Seafood. We didn't stop by and see it, but definitely a place to try. This is a family-owned and operated business that has served Richmond since 1977. They are a one-stop shop for meals centered around fresh fish and shellfish, and also have a variety of local sauces, seasonings, and produce. Students who live in this area and attend public school go to Chesterfield County's Bon Air Elementary, Robius Middle, and James River High School. Chesterfield County Public Schools have 7 national Blue Ribbon schools, 7 national Title I distinguished schools, and 100% of the schools are accredited.
So what do you think? Does this look like a great place to work, live, and play in RVA? Come join me. I'd love to show you around. Give me a call or shoot me a text at 804-380-6041 or send me an email, whichever is most convenient.